Hey everybody, Robbie Pruitt here with Antler King. I got Mr. Don Kiske right here. We're doing this Q&A session, and I think we're just going to start off with the best question ever.
Be easy on me now.
Oh, come on. I can't figure out. I've been here for almost a day now, and the boat's not hooked onto the truck. Why aren't we fishing?
Well, the batteries are charged.
Man.
But we got a slave driver behind the camera there who thinks we need to be doing the old Santa King stuff.
This is horrible. I was looking forward to catching some crappie, maybe get down and catch a walleye or two.
I agree with you. It's about time.
And we're talking about food plots. I mean, we need to rethink this a little bit next time.
I know it. And the bucks are still carrying, it would be shed hunting.
Well, so. That's true. That is true. But, well, Don, you know, you've been doing this a long time.
And I'm old, so yes.
I'm falling right behind you right now. But I want to know, you know, everybody out there sees you hunting on film. They see you brushing in your blinds. You're hunting over corn. What do you do with your greens? I mean, what's your favorite product to use? How do you use it, and why do you use it?
Well, that's a great question, actually. You know, I tell a lot of people I have a lot of faith in the corn and the soybeans, but here lately, as warm as our falls have been, and the winter, you know, it's getting so hot during late season,
yep.
I can't stress the importance of the green plots. And I'm really noticing now that you have to incorporate green into every one of my plots. My favorite thing to do is I'll go into my cornfield, and I'll do the outside perimeter with at least maybe 20 to 30 yards of three different products, either the lights out, the slam dunk turnips or radishes, and the honey hole turnips.
Yep. Yep.
And if I like to plant them separately, so they actually make the bowl.
Absolutely.
And then you plant the oats in September.
Right.
But, I mean, sometimes it gets too late. You know, the weather doesn't work out, so you've
right.
got to plant them together, but you still get the tops. They eat the tops great too, and you'll make a little turnip or a little radish. So
absolutely.
That's really worked well for me because we brush our blinds into the corn, like you said. And I still got the green incorporated into my plots.
Yep. And I've noticed that you run them up the sides and everything like that.
Absolutely.
So it works out perfect.
During the year, once you keep moving your blind back, you mm-hmm. still got the green on both sides. Instead of planting all the green clear at that end, it doesn't do you no good if it's 100 yards out there.
That's great.
So keep the deer in the zone, you know.
Perfect. All right. You guys heard it from the man that knows the best.
I don't know about that.
All right. Catch us next week for the next episode. You won't want to miss it.